Hello friends, welcome to Study Algorithms, a place where I simplify programming questions for you with some really easy to understand examples. Before I begin this video, I want to let you know that a text-based explanation of all the content of this channel is available on the website studyalgorithms.com. Do check it out if you still have doubts after the end of this video. Today in this video, we would be understanding bubble sort. First, I will tell you briefly about sorting and why there are so many methods available to sort. Next, I will actually do bubble sort live in front of you, and then going forward, we would be looking at the code followed by a dry run. So, without further ado, let's get started. In one of my previous videos, I discussed about the insertion sort. Check the link in the description below or you can click right over here. Now, insertion sort works perfectly, and it would work for almost all of the test cases. But then, why do you have so many sorting techniques available? I bet you would have seen method A of sorting, method B of sorting, and method C of sorting. And yet again, you have bubble sort and insertion sort as two different techniques of sorting. Take a moment to think, why is that so? Because before we start talking about bubble sort, you should know why it even exists. Well, that is because sorting in itself is a problem, and as you know, a problem can be solved in multiple ways. Each solution would have some or the other disadvantages or advantages over the other one. Bubble sort, for instance, is a really great example for beginners to understand the concepts of sorting. And bubble sort performs very well when your array or your set of elements is in a nearly sorted condition. You might be surprised to know that in some rare cases, a bubble sort algorithm can actually perform better than a quick sort algorithm. Let us now dive into the solution to see how actually a bubble sort algorithm works. The best way to understand bubble sort would be by an example. Let us say you have to sort this array. Before starting, you might also be wondering, where does the name bubble sort come from? I don't know the exact etymology, but the way I like to think it is, suppose you have an ocean like this. And at the bottom of the ocean, you have a small bubble. Now, as this bubble will move up, it will increase in size, right? And it would have the largest size at the surface of the ocean. So what is happening is, as the bubble moves up, its size increases. And in bubble sort, after every iteration, the maximum element will bubble towards the very end. We will see how in just a moment. The basic idea behind bubble sort is that you compare two adjacent elements, and if they are not sorted, you swap them. So the best way to start would be from the beginning, right? So I go in the beginning and I compare 5 and 6. Since they are already sorted, hence we don't need to do anything about it. Moving forward, I go on to 6 and 9. Now, these are also sorted, so I don't do anything about it. Moving one step ahead, I see 9 and 4. This time, they are not sorted because 9 is greater than 4. So we would swap them out. Once I swap them, my array would become. Moving forward, we would be comparing 9 and 8. Again, these two are not sorted. 9 is greater than 8. So what do we do is, we swap both of these elements. Now, comparing it for the one last time, we compare 9 and 2. Once again, these are not sorted and 9 is greater than 2. So we would sort them as well. This completes one iteration of bubble sort. And you could easily see that in one iteration, one element bubbled towards the very end, and hence the name bubble sort. Does this mean that after two iterations, two largest elements will bubble towards the very end? Let us quickly do one more iteration of this bubble sort. Starting from the beginning, we go and compare 5 and 6. These are already sorted, so we don't do anything. Moving ahead, I see 6 and 4. Now, 6 is greater than 4, so I would need to swap both of them. After I swap them, my array becomes 6 and 8. These are already in the correct order, so we don't do anything about it. Moving ahead, I would be comparing 8 and 2. Now, 8 is greater than 2 and it's not sorted. What does that mean? We swap them. Now, this completes two iterations of the bubble sort. What happened in two iterations is, at the end of two iterations, the largest two elements have bubbled towards the very end. If you do it one more time, three elements should come towards the very end. I'll do it quickly for you. Now, this concludes three iterations of the bubble sort. And as you can see, at the end of three iterations, the largest three numbers have bubbled towards the very end. If you keep on iterating this again and again, all the way up till six iterations, your array would be eventually sorted. And this is how a bubble sort works in the background. Now let us try to look at the dry run of the code and see how it actually works. To understand the dry run, I am taking the same example array that we just discussed. On the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to perform a bubble sort. And on the right, we would be seeing how it goes into action. So, n is my array length. In this case, the value of n is 6. Next, we have a for loop of I. Now, I ranges from 0 up till 5. And I is keeping a track of every iteration. So, after one iteration, the largest element should go towards the end. When I completes two iterations, two largest elements would bubble towards the very end. So, I is keeping a track of that. Going forward, I have a loop j. Now, this loop is always starting from the beginning and it tries to compare two adjacent elements over here. If these elements are not in the sorted order, it would swap them. So, let us just try to start off our dry run. The value of I starts from 0 and the value of j starts from 0. That means we are pointing at the first element. Then we compare array at j and j plus 1. So, we are comparing 5 and 6. Since they are in the sorted order, we won't be swapping them. Moving forward, the value of j changes to 1. So I'm pointing at 6. Now I would be comparing 6 and 9. Since they are also in the sorted order, no change is required. Moving ahead, the value of j changes to 2. And I'm pointing at 9. This time, when I compare 9 and 4, 9 is greater than 4. And hence, this part of the code will execute. And over here, we are swapping these two elements. So when this executes, our array becomes 9. And this feels very similar to the example that we just discussed. Going ahead, the value of j now changes to 3. So I'm pointing over here, and now I compare 9 and 8. Once again, 9 is greater than 8, so I would be swapping them. Moving on, the value of j now changes to 4 and I'm pointing at this element. I again compare 9 and the next element. Once again, 9 is greater than 2, so we would need to swap them out. And hence you see, our results look very similar to the one we just discussed a couple of minutes ago. At this time, the for loop of I ends and hence we are completing one iteration. And at the end of one iteration, what happened is one element which was their maximum, got bubbled towards the very end. Similarly, now we would go on to I equals to 1, and then 2, and then 3, and then so on. You get the idea, because it is exactly the way we discussed in our previous example. So you can understand that once this code completes and your value of I reaches all the way up till 5, then you will have all the 5 elements bubble towards the very end. And hence your array will eventually become sorted. The time complexity of a bubble sort algorithm is order of n squared. This is because of the two for loops that we have in there. I hope this video gave you a good insight about the bubble sort algorithm and how it can be used in computer programming. I just took the example of numbers, but this sorting technique can be used to sort any form of characters as well. Anything that follows a certain sequence can be sorted using this method. As for my departing thoughts, take a moment to think where the bubble sort algorithm would not be a good idea. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I would love to discuss them with you. If you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify these programming concepts for you. Until then, see ya!